It's an absolute honour to have you here with us at the Children's BAFTAs. Of all the accolades and awards you've won in your great career, what does this special award tonight particularly mean to you?
Well, I think it's quite wonderful and totally unexpected, and I'm just thrilled to bits. And, you know, you never ever think, the very word BAFTA, you think of great glamorous film stars and everything, and a sort of slightly ageing children's writer. No, you don't imagine it to happen, but I'm thrilled to bits, I really am. I really do feel that children's television now offers such a variety, and I've been so impressed with the adaptations of my books, and particularly the Hetty Feathers series that's running now, and The Dumping Ground, which is the spin-off of Tracy Beaker. They've taken such pains. Everybody to do the different productions cares so much. And there's never a feeling of, oh, it's only children's television. It's a feeling of it has to be very special because it's children's television. And I love that. I think children do continue to read. If you give a child a book and say, here, read that, it's good for you, they probably, you know, won't be that bothered. But I think particularly watching something on television, if they like it, they will actually then, if there is a book, go to the book. So I think, you know, it's a reciprocal thing. And I mean, look at adults' television. If there's a serialisation of Jane Austen, say, you know, Emma or Pride and Prejudice immediately goes up in the paperback charts. So it really works. Not that I'm comparing myself to Jane Austen, but still. Slightly ridiculously, the stage version of Hetty Feather had a musical interlude, and they've made it into a pop single to be released in December. So although I'm not singing or I'm not dancing, I could say I might be a very minor pop star. You never know.